My name is Stephen San Juan, been working in the solar industry for about 10 years now. Most recently, I started Rise Renewable Energy, and we offer safety and technical training for the renewables industries, both wind, EV, battery, and solar. We're here at a beautiful solar site, the Antelope Valley Solar Ranch, or AVSR, in Antelope Valley, California. Now, this site has been commissioned for almost 10 years, but you still hear the sound of solar, which typically is a quiet day. You're out in the middle of the desert, there's not a whole lot going on except the general hum of power production. As we like to call it in the industry, the sound of money. i-vcurve tracing is a measurement of a PV array, either an individual module or a larger string or series of strings. And what it's doing is it's measuring the maximum potential current as compared to the maximum potential voltage of a circuit. And it produces a curve when you measure all this stuff out and gives you the health of the PV array. When you're doing an i-vcurve, you'll need the actual i-vcurve tracer itself to take the measurements. And what that's doing is it's varying the resistance of the circuit to balance out the maximum potential current of the circuit as well as the maximum potential voltage of the circuit. When doing it, you'll also have to have the environmental data. Every module manufacturer, when they originally test their system, has what's called standard test conditions, or STCs. So you have to make sure that you are as close to those as possible when in the field. So you'll typically have an irradiance meter and a temperature sensor to find out in your particular installation, what is that currently? And the i-vcurve tracer can then calculate out, based on that information, what power you should be getting out of it. One of the biggest challenges across all installations is the environment in which you're actually doing the test in. So weather is very rarely cooperative. Even in an environment like this in Antelope Valley, California, clouds come out of nowhere, the temperature doesn't quite work right, the soiling of the module isn't exactly what it's supposed to be. All of these things play into getting a good i-vcurve trace and actually getting that data. Across the US, you have different factors, whether it's heavy clouds, rain, winter conditions, and ideally, you would have a day like today to do an i-vcurve trace, but very rarely does your schedule allow for that. Typically, you do an i-vcurve trace for troubleshooting purposes. I want to know how my site is currently operating. Is it being efficient? So soiling and shading are the biggest hazards when it comes to good power production of a module. And it's not always easily identifiable. Depending on the module type, whether it's a specific manufacturer or a specific type, different kinds of soiling over time, whether it's through wildlife or just dust, causes issues. And so finding that degradation over time is really important. Also, if you have a damaged module, whether it's a hot cell or a dead cell, you can find those kinds of faults within the system. More recently, in the last couple of years, a lot of owners are starting to find degradation over time. Initially, 10 years ago, 2% every year was kind of the common thought, where all modules would just have a slight 2% degradation year over year. Through annual i-vcurve tracing, they're finding it's about 4 to 5%, and maybe with some manufacturers, even higher. i-vcurve tracing should be done regularly and frequently. Obviously, at the initial installation of the project, you need to have a baseline of where you're at. Are my modules working as the site was designed? Year over year, you want to make sure that you're continuing to do that. A lot of companies have landed on about 10% of a project to see what is that year over year degradation, and then as needed for specific troubleshooting purposes. Environmental factors have a huge impact on how you can do your i-vcurve. Ideally, you want to have whatever the STCs or standard test conditions signify. Here in Antelope Valley, you probably want to do it at about this time of day. You have plenty of sunlight and it's not too hot. In the afternoon, now you're getting to a higher temperature, which does in itself degrade that module production. In the southeast or northeast, where it's a little bit cooler, higher humidity, you always want to make sure you're checking that weather forecast for your region. When performing an i-vcurve trace, just like with any electrical test, you have to understand the rating of the system that you're in front of, what the voltage and the current potential is. This relates to your arc flash and shock danger. So when you're opening up an energized electrical cabinet, which when doing an IV curve trace, you have to have power present, you have to understand what is the voltage rating. Most solar installations are either 600 volts DC, 1000 volts DC, or 1500 volts DC. Understanding that and making sure that you have the appropriate tool for the job will ensure that there's no technician inserted arc fault. In addition to that, you have to wear the appropriate PPE. When performing any sort of electrical test, IV curve tracing, you have to have reports that go to the end user, whoever the client is or the owner is. Depending on what the purpose of the trace is going to change in what type of reporting. So if I'm going to a job site troubleshooting a string or a module, typically it's going to be whatever the failure was found and whatever corrective actions were done. So I can say, I found 3 bad modules due to dead cells. We replaced those 3 modules. Here's the part numbers. If I'm doing a year-over-year degradation test, finding out what is the general health of my PV array, I might say, based on last year's checks, I am now seeing a 4, 5, 6, 10% degradation and what corrective actions need to be done. Depending on that application, if I'm an owner, it could just be simple, hey, I'm now going to contact this company to come and repair these things and whatever reports are required with that action. If I have an independent service provider that's coming in and doing it, I would then, of course, list out what was found and what recommendations would be from there.